Okay, everyone, I wanted to get back to you about my Hobby Zone Super Cub project. I've been painting it yellow after putting the primer on. I'm really not happy with the way it looks. Let's go outside now and take a look at it, and I can show you what I'm talking about.
Okay, everyone, here we are outside, and here's where I paint the fuselage and let it dry. And I see some issues with it. As it dries, it gets very light. So if you look down the center of the fuselage there, you can see how there's like a lighter spot, and maybe more where the spackling is, it's darker. So maybe looking at where the foam just isn't absorbing the color as well as the spackling is, and I'm just not sure what I'm going to do about it now. I did get some new colored paint that I may go over the yellow with, and may try to fix this here a little bit. Let's go back inside and let me show you that new paint. Okay, guys, so this is the one that I was using. This is the Krylon Color Master Sun Yellow, and I just don't like the way it painted on the foam. And I felt that regardless of how many coats I put on, it still gave me that dull look on the foam. So I went to Home Depot today and I bought another can of paint here, and this is Rust-Oleum Gloss Protective Enamel in orange. So I kind of went a different color with it. Maybe something a little darker would go on the foam better, and maybe get darker and better results. So I went with the orange here. So we're going to have an orange Super Cub. I did get the LED lights for it, so it's going to have full lighting, navigation lighting, and it's going to have the pontoon, so we're going to be able to get some good footage taking off and landing on the river right next door. Okay, guys, so after just one or two coats of this orange Rust-Oleum paint, the airplane really looks nice. I mean, you can still see kind of the bubbles in the sides. Well, let's get a little closer up here. But it's nowhere near like it was with the yellow. And with the yellow, I put on really like a half a dozen coats. So within a few coats, we're really getting some thick paint on there. And because of the color orange, I've decided to go with a Dukes of Hazzard theme. So I'm going to get a couple decals for the plane here. I'm going to get like a 01 for the side like they have on the side of their car, and maybe a couple other things to have us remember Dukes of Hazzard. I don't know if all you guys remember those days. I'm sure a lot of you do, especially from the remake of the movie, and but I just love that show growing up. So this will be my Dukes of Hazzard Hobby Zone Super Cub float plane. So the next step is we're just painting it all up orange, and I got to put it all together. Hopefully I might have it flying by this weekend. The navigation LED lights are on order. They have been shipped. We should get them shortly. Let's go inside. I'll show you the other parts to this plane. Okay, guys, so this is my paint area for the cowling and the vertical and horizontal stab in the back control surfaces. Again, the paint's going on really, really nice. Thick, no issues with the foam degrading or melting or anything like that with the Rust-Oleum. This is just regular Rust-Oleum paint there. One thing to note, I wasn't sure whether I wanted to remove the decals that were on the plane. So the decals come already assembled and installed. You can see it a little there, the stripe that comes down and then over. When you buy these parts after you crash them, they come without the decals, but because it's basically a bind and fly, but they are on there. I decided to leave them there because I know what happens when you try to take the stickers off of this material here. It kind of separates from the foam, and you get like a bubble right there. So I decided to leave them. I'm going to paint them, and we're going to see how it goes. So far, I'm really happy with the color change. I mean, this orange is incredible. Dukes of Hazzard theme, I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully, boy, without the ailerons, because I'm going to save that for later, With just the three-channel airplane, we'll have this up maybe this weekend. Give me 2-3 days with it, put it all together, and we'll have some flight videos here real soon.